Today, it's time for the Q&A video we discussed a few videos ago. Thank you to everyone who posted questions in the comments with hashtag question in front. We'll be taking a look at those, though I can't answer all of the questions just due to video length, and also the fact that some questions were kind of similar to each other. I'll occasionally show footage relevant to the question, but a lot of times I'll just be showing some random gameplay footage, so you have something to look at while I'm rambling. Okay, let's get started. The first question is, why is your channel called Yellow Super Nintendo? I actually thought about the name for a long time when I made the channel. Yes, it is a reference to the fact that Super Nintendo's become yellow after a while. I never had a home console growing up, but the Super Nintendo is the first console I have memories of. I'll always remember running to the electronics section, hearing the sound of Super Mario World getting louder and louder until the lineup of store display kiosks fell into view. I also remember trying to play A Link to the Past at a store display, but I couldn't read yet, so I didn't know what to do. But I still had fun. The reason the channel is called Yellow Super Nintendo is because a yellowed SNES simultaneously reminds me of those early memories, but also the fact that I'm older now, and it's not 1992. It's a bit like talking to a good friend who you've known for a long time. There's that moment when you realize that their hair is starting to gray and they've started putting on some weight. Then you take a look at the mirror yourself and start noticing that you don't really look like you did when you went to high school either. It sounds a bit deep for something that's just the name of a channel, but that was the thought process behind it. I guess I'm just a bit obsessed about things that give me nostalgic feelings. What got you into Disgaea? How did you find out about the franchise? When did you start and stuff like that? Just around the time the PS3 came out, I was given a PS2 as a gift. It was my first home console. I used it to play, you know, Gran Turismo as well as Battlefield. But a few years later, I wanted to dive in a bit deeper. I've been a computer gamer all my life, and finally being able to play games not available on PC was an alluring prospect. So I googled best PS2 games, and some of the games I saw come up were a bunch of obscure Japanese games, like Grim Grimoire, Odin Sphere, Okami, and of course Disgaea. Disgaea seemed really interesting because I never really played turn-based games all that much, and it seemed really deep too. At the same time, I wanted to give anime a go as well. As a kid, I watched a few things that you could see on TV, but most of it didn't appeal to me except for Pokemon and some other ones here and there. But definitely not anything that most anime fans liked at the time, like Dragon Ball, Yu-Gi-Oh, and especially not stuff like Bleach, Naruto, or One Piece. But I figured there's probably something that's more obscure that I'd enjoy. For me, it was the same with metal music. As a kid, I never really liked listening to metal, but then I started diving into obscure genres like death metal, black metal, doom, grindcore, and even more specific subgenres like black and death, atmospheric black metal, pagan black metal, and all that stuff. And I really enjoyed that music, yet something like Metallica, which is probably what, you know, most metalheads will bring up all the time, doesn't really do anything for me. So I just applied that same thinking to anime and video games and dived right into the niche corner. So I ended up watching the Disgaea anime to see if I'd like the story, and I did enjoy it. There was this type of humor I never really saw anywhere else before. Afterwards, I got Disgaea for the PS2, and that's where my love of obscure Japanese games started. Later, I had the desire to talk about Japanese games, and that's where the channel got its start. Will you make a where to start video for the DS or 3DS? The short answer is yes. I don't have any immediate plans, but I wouldn't be surprised if I had the urge to make one or both sometime this year. There's some non-Nintendo stuff planned as well, which may or may not come first. I already did time to buy videos on the DS and 3DS, but I'll definitely still do where to start videos on them. I've got a few ideas to make those videos a bit different from their time to buy counterparts. What game series do you like the most, Senran Kagura, Neptunia, or Disgaea? Well, first of all, thank you for the well wishes there. Those three games get a lot of coverage on the channel, as you probably already know. I always think of them as the holy trinity of Japanese games, at least on my channel. Almost every game-centric series I do will include those three at some point. It's hard to say which I like more because there are different reasons why I would like one more over the other. For pure gameplay, I think it would be Senran Kagura. Real-time gameplay is just something I gravitate towards naturally. The games aren't super long, which is nice for me, and I get a kick out of the fan service. The gameplay is really satisfying. Those games have a real stress-relieving quality to them. Neptunia I like because of different reasons. It's more about the humor, the story, and the characters for me. Not that I don't like Zenran Kagura characters or anything, of course. I did talk about some of the problems the recent games have, but I generally still like the game's humor, or the franchise's humor overall, and I also like the setting and the world of Neptunia. I just wish they'd stop memeing so hard in the dialogue. I definitely prefer how things were during the PS3 era. The only game that had a similar feel in terms of humor was Super Dimension. The dialogue was hilarious. A lot of the newer games do this, "Oh look, I'm making a joke, and now I'm going to explain it because I'm going to assume the player is an idiot," sort of thing. Disgaea is the most polished out of all the three franchises in my opinion. I think the storylines and gameplay are more consistent in Disgaea than with the other two. But it takes more time to play through them, which is a problem for me, because I don't have that much time. I still haven't finished Disgaea 5 despite getting it when it came out years ago. With the exception of D2, it's also nice to have a new cast every game. That way it's a new experience, and it also means that characters from past games won't get stale from being in the spotlight all the time. So I'd say overall, I like them about equally for different reasons. It just depends on the mood. What kind of music do you like? I think I kind of answered this question already. Lots of metal, the extreme stuff. I like a lot of different genres though, so that doesn't really paint a whole picture. I'm a huge fan of Jack White, so anything he's involved in I listen to, including the White Stripes of course. Interestingly enough, in the 90s, almost all of the things I listened to was basically electronic music. The one artist I still listen to from back then is Mr. Oizo. I like both his old and newer stuff. I also listen to anime soundtracks, which can range from anything to, from classical to folk to electronic. I could go on and on here, but as you can tell, it's all over the place. Do you have any pets? Love the channel, by the way. Always top quality stuff. Well, thank you for the kind words there. To answer your question, no, I don't have any pets. I love cats, but I'm really quite allergic to them, which is sad. Who is your favorite Zenran Kagura character? It doesn't matter if you can play as her or not. That's an easy one, I don't even have to think about that. That would be Murasaki. She's a really pessimistic person, which is something I can relate to. For me, it's very natural to think half glass empty rather than half full with almost anything in life. Not that I'm a tragic downer who walks, the streets in a cloud of despair or anything. It's more like that my first thoughts about something usually is negative. There's also something really amusing about her constant negativity. When she keeps commenting how she, shouldn't have left her room or she wants to go home. There's a bit of an Eeyore kind of quality, I think. A bit of a strange parallel, but for some reason that's what I thought of. Do you watch a lot of anime? If so, what are some of your favorite series? I used to watch a lot of anime, but not so much these days. I just don't have the time anymore. A bit like music, my tastes are all over the place. I like slice of life for their relaxing and nostalgic attributes. Some standout ones from the top of my head are K-On!, Lucky Star, Minamike, and Miss Kobayashi's Dragon Maid. Here's a fun fact. If you ever watch Lucky Star, you'll see the exact years the anime takes place in because of the calendars you see in the background. With a bit of math, I found out that the main characters are born exactly the same year as me. Saitokai Yakuindomo, I guess, counts as slice of life too. I find the dirty jokes really funny. It sometimes feels forced, but it's amazing once it fits. A certain magical index and scientific railgun I like very much despite my usual aversion to mixing magic and science. The current season of Index is one of the only shows I'm watching at the moment. I'm actually currently also rewatching Railgun. I'm also a fan of various shows produced by Studio Shaft like the Monogatari series, Madoka Magica, and especially Sayonara Setsubou Sensei. Strike Witches is another one I really enjoy. It's a crazy concept, but I somehow like the world that they've created in there for some reason. Spice and Wolf was amazing. I love that show, as well as the books and the anime. I'm behind on the books, though, and the manga for that matter. The anime has some amazing music, and speaking of amazing music, Higurashi is my favorite horror anime. I could go on and on like with music, but my favorite anime overall is something I bet nobody knows, or at least only a few people have heard of. It's called Sora no Woto, or Sound of the Sky. I love it so much. I like how it slowly builds up. I like how you can analyze stuff like background details like crazy. There's so many subtle details spread throughout the show. But at the same time, it's vague and it makes you wonder about the things you don't see about the characters or the world they live in. The soundtrack is beautiful too. I've watched through it numerous times, but I haven't watched the show or listened to the soundtrack in years in hopes that I'll forget the details about it. Then several years from now, I'll watch it again, and it'll be like having a vague dream unveiled in front of your eyes. Like an old memory that you're clinging to, and you start remembering it as soon as you see the scenes unfold before you. And this will be the last question here. Will you make a how to maintain a console video? That is very possible. I have a list of video ideas, and something similar has been on that list for a while now. The problem is that things can get very specific for different consoles, so in my opinion, it would be better to make videos for specific systems rather than just one, you know, all-encompassing video, which could be too broad and not really help everyone or anyone. Another way the subject could be approached is to split the difference and group consoles together by era or maybe even by brand. The subject is interesting, but I don't know when I'll get into that. I think that's enough for today, though. I think the video's been going on for a decent while now. Thanks for everyone who asked questions. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.